Hey, it's Dennis, VE3BF, and it's time to do some upgrades to the antenna here at the Home Shack. So I've chosen this Ultimax. It's an 8040 Double Bazooka antenna. It's 103 feet long. It's got some coaxial traps, so it's not a traditional bazooka because there is no 300 ohm twin lead here, so it's a coaxial antenna. And according to the instructions, it is set for 40 meters before the coil, so there's no adjustments there. It's supposed to give me the whole band as far as an acceptable SWR. We'll be checking that out in the next part of the video. And then there's a whip here, and there is an adjustment on the coax here that you can bring back and forth. Now the instructions say that it's resonant at around 3650. We'll see where that is. And the instructions say to pull back the coax and move this insulator about 3 to 6 inches back in different steps. And once you get to the ideal SWR, the instructions say to add in some more tie wraps to tighten it up and make it stable. So we're going to install this up on the roof, and we're going to be putting it at roughly 40 feet. 35 to 40 feet. I haven't exactly measured it 100% with the tape measure yet, but hopefully that will work out. According to the instructions, that's where we need to be. So let's take a look at the build construction. Let's start off with the main hub here, the hang point. Now, there is some hint of sealant here down below. So this is sealed down here. There's two small holes to let moisture out from underneath. One of the things that I found a little bit surprising is that there is no sealant here around the coax. Now, that might be okay in warmer climates, but here we've got ice in Canada. And so I'm gonna pop some silicone on there and around here, make sure that everything's weather sealed so that the eye up here is sealed. We'll pop some silicone there. And in along here, right in here, we'll pop some silicone in there so that no moisture can get in. I'm more worried about ice. The problem with in Canada here is we get freezing rain. That goes in there, freezes in. Those little holes are not going to let anything out. So we'll leave that open and we'll seal this up here, make it a bit better. Now, on the coils, really well wrapped, and looks like it's been heat shrank a little bit. And it's doing a great job here. Everything seems to be well sealed up. And the only thing that I noticed is that this hardware was loose. Now it's probably for packing. So we just tightened everything up and got it ready. So here's the adjustment point. So a single tie wrap here, and it's not very tight. And so we're supposed to pull that back or let it out, depending on where you want your SWR to be. All right, so here it is. Put some silicone in around here, two nylon tie wraps on the D-ring here. That's my breakaway point for ice in case we get too much ice over the winter. I want that to break off. These are UV resistant, so they're not gonna be an issue here. And they're good in the cold as well. Put the silicone in so that we don't get any migration of water all the way through. It looks a little ugly, but you know what? It is what it is. You're not going to see that once it gets up in the air. I am going to take the sticker off just to make it as stealth as possible. Sorry, Ultimax, but that's the kit. And I should mention here that I'm not being paid by Ultimax to do this review. This is just something that I wanted to do myself. I didn't see a whole lot of documentation other than the reviews on eHam that were all positive on this antenna. So I hope that this helps you make your decision on an antenna that may be right for you. Well, a couple of weeks have gone by since I did the original footage from the outdoor. A lot of things have changed. We had a bit of a storm here, a couple of days, actually about a week of high winds, and gave me a chance to watch the trees and watch how things were moving. And I got a bit nervous. The antenna, the Double Bazooka, it's a bit heavy. It's at about 6 pounds, 3 to 6 pounds. And that's a lot of stress on wires and stuff. The tree that I originally wanted to use in the front yard, it's got a lot of sway, and it's not as tall as I anticipated. I was getting some interference from the eaves trough and from the eave, which is aluminum. Just couldn't get the antenna up high enough, and there was so much sway in the tree that if I tried to put a pulley up there It was just going to be crazy. Plus, I was going to get some interference from the branches. So I had to rethink things. And luckily, I've got good neighbors. I've been in this neighborhood for 18 years. And my neighbors were kind enough to let me use their yard. And so I tied the antenna to the fence. And well, the instructions say 30 to 35 feet. Unfortunately, it just didn't work out. Couldn't do it. So I'm at 25 feet at the peak. And I come down to about 10 feet off the ground at one end and about 8.5 feet off the ground at the far end. And you know what? It worked. Okay, so let's talk resonance on 80 meters. On 80 meters, I'm at 3.578 megahertz, 2:1. And that goes all the way to 3.838 megahertz at 2:1. And everything in below that, or in everything in between, it becomes a nice flat area. Lots of flat area, 3,700 to 3,780. I'm under 1.5 to 1, and flat right at 3,730. Really, really nice. That's where I like to operate. So that's why I've tuned the band that way, or tuned the antenna that way, I should say. On the 40 meter side, 7 megahertz, 1.5 to 1. It dips down and flat across a good portion of the band. And then I get right up to 7.290, and that's where I hit 2:1. So I've got this little 10 KC area there where I need the tuner. That's pretty cool. Very, very impressed with that. Now, I've been criticized about this on other videos. The bands are in terrible condition. I'm recording this in the morning, and I've got lots of noise, atmospheric noise, all kinds of different stuff. I've never seen the bands this bad, so it's not a fair, it's not fair to show you what the antenna is doing. When I didn't have the camera on last night, I was talking to the Canary Islands. I'm in Ottawa, so I mean, that's in Africa. That's pretty cool. I talked across the country from Newfoundland all the way out to Manitoba on 80 meters, and I've been getting fantastic signal reports when the band's been alive on 40. Right now they're not. I'm not going to bore you with listening to static. One thing I may mention is the antenna. I've got a sloper. We'll show you that outside, which is my NFED. I did a video on that a little while ago. And the sloper, I'm getting on the 40 meter and the 80 meter band about 1.5 S units less. Now, it's a shorter antenna. It's a compromise antenna. So, you know, it is what it is. It's oriented in a different direction, so that also has something to do with it. But what is really cool is if I've got band noise on one antenna, I can switch to the other antenna for receive, and I can pull in the station a little bit better. So I've got the opportunity of two antennas that I can switch back and forth from. Now, the Double Bazooka is the only antenna that I can run my amplifier on. So, that's the advantage. That's why I wanted it there. And so that gives me that extra power when I want it. The high end Fed is only rated for 200 watts, so I can't run the amp on yet. Anyway, that's the scoop. Let's take a peek at some SWR curves. All right, so let's take a look at the 80 meter band here. We'll turn down the volume so we don't get some static. One of my pet peeves about videos is listening to HF static. All right, 35.85, and we're on low power, and nobody there. We've got 2:1 SWR. Moving up the band here just a little bit, about 40 KCs. We're under 1.5. Okay, up a little bit more, 36.50. Nothing there. Lots of static on the air. 1.1. And let's go to 3,700, thereabouts. Nobody there. 1:1. 50. Nobody there. Still 1:1. Nobody there. 1.1, 1.2. thereabouts, no signal. We're at 1.5. We're about the upper limit, somewhere in around here. Yeah, we're at 2:1. 2 to 1, 2 to 1, just climbing a little bit over 2. We're over 2 here. So 2 to 1, 3840 thereabouts. So that's pretty good bandwidth on 80 meters. So here we are on 40 meters at the bottom of the band. Not interfering with anybody. We're only putting out 5 watts, 1.5 to 1. Not interfering with anybody here. Somebody tuning up, so we can see that. So just up 50 kcs and we're at 1 to 1. ...7100 thereabouts. Nobody there. 1 to 1. Still 1 to 1. At 7.2, 1.1 to 1. 7.248, 1.5 to 1. And we make it up here to our upper limit. And 2 to 1. 2 to 1 at 7.290. So pretty good bandwidth. Well, there you have it. Almost the entire 40, lots of the 80 and 75 without a tuner. I'm really excited about working some when the conditions get better. I'll keep adding some show notes, let you guys know how the antenna is performing as time goes on. And if you hear me on the air, give me a shout, give me a signal report. I want to hear from you. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. That way you'll find out when I'm posting other videos. I've got a few more planned for you guys. And that's about it. 7-3 for now. Catch you on the next one.